So let us start with the problem number 2. First of all, as we said earlier, that we have to read out the problem. Let P1 is equal to I is equal to 100010001. So 6 matrices are given over here, and all these matrices are in such a way that only two digits are there. So first of all, we will read out these matrices. This is P1. P2 is 100001010. P3 is 010100001. Then P4 is 010001100. Then P5 is 001100010. And P6, last one, is 001010100. These 6 matrices are given, and one expression is given. X is equal to sigma k is equal to 1 to 6 pk into matrix is given 2 1 3 1 0 2 3 2 1 into pk transpose. Here t is given, where pkt denotes the transpose of the matrix pk. That means pk transpose is given over here, and then which of the following options are correct. अगेन सेम टाइप ऑफ मैथमेटिकल प्रॉब्लम इज देयर. सो आपको ये देखना है कि मैथमेटिक्स का जो ये प्रॉब्लम है, जो पहला प्रॉब्लम था, उसी बेस पे पूछा गया है. तो देखिए आप, इज और आर इज आस्क्ड हियर है. सो वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट मल्टीपल ऑप्शंस आर करेक्ट ओवर हियर. मिनिमम वन ऑप्शन इज करेक्ट, और मे बी पॉसिबल दैट 4 out of 4 ऑप्शंस मेड बी करेक्ट. सो आपको क्या करना है, जैसे मैंने पहले बताया, आईआईटी में आपको जाना है तो आपको प्रैक्टिस करनी पड़ेगी. भैया मैथमेटिक्स ऐसा सब्जेक्ट है कि आपको प्रैक्टिस के बिना कुछ भी नहीं मिलने वाला. मैथमेटिक्स इज नॉट थ्योरेटिकल, 100% प्योरली प्रैक्टिकल, प्योरली प्रैक्टिस सब्जेक्ट. सो दैट्स व्हाई दिस काइंड ऑफ एग्जांपल्स आर एडवांस लेवल. यू हैव टू प्रैक्टिस एज मच एज पॉसिबल. नो वन इज गोइंग टू स्टॉप यू फ्रॉम गेटिंग 100% मार्क इन मैथमेटिक्स स्पेशली. सो आई विल टेल आफ्टर दैट हाउ टू डू स्टडी एंड हाउ टू फोकस द मैथमेटिक्स. बिफोर गोइंग टू दैट, वी विल सॉल्व दिस. So see the option number 1 first, then we will step by step go to the B, C and D options. So what is the option number 1? X is a symmetric matrix. The statement is given, X is a symmetric matrix. Just we have to tell this statement is correct or incorrect. That's the question. So what is meant by the symmetric matrix? Definition of symmetric matrix is that when Aij is equal to Aji of a matrix, so that A is an element of a matrix. I is the serial number for row and J is the serial number for column. When such a condition is fulfilled, then matrix is known as symmetric matrix. Also, another condition is that when A is a matrix is equal to its transpose. When a matrix A is equal to transpose of its own, then the matrix A is also called as symmetric matrix. So we will solve by simplified method over here. Rather than solving the lengthy problem, we will solve with the short formulas here. So, first of all, assume or let Q be the matrix equal to 2 1 3 1 0 2 3 2 1. Okay, let Q be the matrix equal to 2 1 3 1 0 2 3 2 1. Now put this value q into this expression, we will get x is equal to sigma k is equal to 1 to 6 pk into q into pk transpose. Okay, pk into q into pk transpose. Now we have to expand this. After removing this symbol, we will get p1. The numbers are given from 1 to 6. So we have to write till 6 is achieved. P1 into Q into P1 transpose plus P2 into Q into P2 transpose plus P3 into Q into P3 transpose. Likewise, we have to continue till P6 comes, and we will get P3 into Q into P3 transpose. So what we have to do here is that we have to check whether X is equal to its transpose or not. We have to check X is equal to its transpose or not, we will get the required information. Now we will take transpose on both the sides. So take the transpose of x on LHS. So automatically we will get its transpose on right hand side also. So we will get P1Q P1T plus P2Q P2 transpose plus P3Q P3 transpose dash 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 P6, sorry, P6 is here. P6 plus P6Q P6 transpose and transpose is closed by raising over the bracket. So now we have been known of the formula that we know A plus B transpose is equal to A transpose and B transpose. We know that formula. A plus B bracket transpose is equal to transpose of A into transpose of B. Similarly, we have to apply this over here and rewrite this bottom equation into the top side. So I will erase due to the space limitation. I will erase the top equation. So now x transpose is equal to p1 q p1 t into bracket transpose plus p2 q p2 transpose of the transpose, then dash 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 till p6 is achieved, p6 q p6 transpose, then again transpose. So again there one formula comes that when we know that the formula a b c is the bracket, if there is a bracket transpose like that, we can expand this using c transpose, b transpose and a transpose. You can observe this rule here. What the rule tells is that when a b c is given, then serial order is disturb in the reverse order. C comes first, B comes second and A comes third when we expand this equation. Likewise, here we have to do the same things. So understand the things here. Assume P1 as A and assume QP as B. So we will get that. So we will take here A, B, C. Now it will reverse when transpose comes inside the bracket. X transpose is equal to becomes P transpose and transpose of the bracket again, Q transpose, then P transpose. Okay. Then what comes here? P2 transpose, bracket transpose into Q transpose into P2 transpose. Likewise, it is continued till P6. Now here we will observe that what is the transpose of transpose. Transpose of transpose means TT gets cancelled, it will remain only P. So what is remaining? P, Q transpose and P transpose. Then here P2 Q into Q transpose. Likewise, equation continues. So here we get that summation pk q and pk transpose overall transpose, sorry, transpose is not here. So this is the value of x. So we have been proved that transpose of x is equal to x. So we get that X is a symmetric matrix. What is the condition for the matrix to be symmetric? When a matrix is equal to its transpose, then that matrix is symmetric. Here, this condition has been proved that transpose of the X is equal to X, because here this equation has been solved. Likewise, that key transpose has been came inside the bracket and we have solved that bracket. Transpose are rearranged the sequence and we can get Q here the constant. There is no requirement of transpose in the Q. Only these two positions has been arranged, rearranged, and we get the actual value of X matrix. So we get X transpose equal to X. So let us solve the option number second. Option number second. the sum of diagonal entries is 18. What is meant by the diagonal elements? Suppose this is a matrix and the elements in the imaginary this diagonal are the diagonal elements. Then sum of these elements is called a sum of diagonal elements. So it will be very lengthy when we will calculate each and every elements matrix and then add it. So that's why we will just use a simple formula to calculate this. We have to use the trace formula. So what is meant by the trace? If you apply the trace A, this means the summation of the diagonal elements. Summation of diagonal elements. Likewise, we will apply this trace formula here. Trace X is equal to summation K is equal to 0 to N into trace PK into Q into PK transpose. So this has been applied over here, transpose of PK, and so there is one formula that transpose of A into B becomes transpose of B into A. So here assume that PK is A and QPKT is B. So there is no change in this. K is equal to 0 to N transpose in bracket Q PKT into PK. Okay. So we get QPKT into PK. But if we observe each and every matrix given here, suppose I will give one example. 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. This is P1 matrix. All matrix have a condition that the sum of horizontal elements, that is elements in the row, is 1 in each row. When the sum of horizontal elements in a row is 1, then that matrix is called as orthogonal matrix. Here we can observe that all the matrix given P1 to P6, the sum is 1, that's why all the matrix are orthogonal matrix. So the situation for the orthogonal matrix is that A into A transpose is equal to I, that means identity matrix. So here, since the all the matrices are orthogonal, here the condition becomes PK transpose into PK becomes I. Sigma K is equal to N to sigma K is equal to 0 to N transpose Q into I. So again, we know that if we multiply by I to any of the matrix, then value becomes that original value. That means if Q into I is there, it becomes Q. Therefore, summation K is equal to 0 to N becomes transpose of Q. So we know that Q, what is Q? Q is the matrix which we have been assumed that Q is equal to 2, 1, 3, 1, 0, 2. 0, 1, 0. This is the Q we have been assumed earlier where we were solving the example. We were assumed that Q. So what is the sum of diagonal elements? Sorry, here is 1, 3, 2, 1. So see the diagonal elements of the Q. 2 plus 1, 3. What is the trace of Q? Here, summation K is equal to 0 to N. Trace of Q is 3. Okay. Now here N is 6 because 6 matrices are given and equation becomes 6 into 3 is equal to 18. So what does it tell that key? The sum of the diagonal elements of entries of the matrix X is 18. Thus equation or the option 2 is also true. Now let us solve the option number 3. Now let us solve the option number 3. So for our convenience, we will use or solve firstly the option number 4 because it will be easy to solve the option number 3 after completing the option number 4. So first of all we will take the fourth option, that if x into 1 1 1 matrix is equal to alpha 1 1 1 then alpha is equal to 30. Just we have to tell whether this statement is yes statement sahi hai ya galat hai, just aapko prove karna hai. To prove karne ke liye ek method hai hum use karenge aur uske baad hum fourth third option dekhenge. So what here has been asked today, x in bracket 1 1 1 is equal to alpha into 1 1 1. So let assume b is equal to vertical matrix 1 1 1. So if you multiply x by b, it becomes summation k is equal to 0 n in bracket pk plus pk into q to pk transpose bracket close and multiplied by b. It gets multiplied by b. Then again we will write here for all these expressions, it will get P1Q P1T transpose plus P2Q P2 transpose plus P3Q P3 transpose. Till 6 we have to continue this. P4Q P4 transpose plus P5Q P5 transpose plus P6 Q P6 transpose. So this is the expansion. Now here it is multiplied by B. Now the distributive law of the matrices says that if the matrix A plus B is multiplied by C, then it becomes AC plus BC. This is the distributive law which is applicable for the matrices also. We have to apply this law in this equation. It will become XB is equal to P1 Q P1 transpose into B plus P2 Q P2 transpose into B plus P3 Q into P3 transpose B, and likewise till P6 Q P6 transpose B. Now here B is taken inside this. Now we have to take the multiplication of this 2 transpose and this B. Now this will become, if we multiply this transpose of P1 with B, see what is the matrix 1, what is the matrix 1, P1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is the diagonal matrix as other elements are 0. So this is the P1, and if we multiply it by B, we know the value of B, 1, 1, 1. Then by multiplying it, we get this gets multiplied by this, this by this, and this gets multiplied by this. We get 1 plus 0 plus 0, 0 plus 1 plus 0, and 0 plus 0 plus 1. For all matrices, if you multiply by B, it becomes vertical matrix 1, 1, 1 as it is. So when we multiply it by transpose of P1 into B, it becomes B. Also we multiply transpose of P2 by B, it becomes P2. Also we multiply by P3, it becomes B. That's why it gets cancelled out and the equation becomes XB is equal to P1 into QB plus P2 into QB plus P3 into QB plus P4 into QB. Now I want to tell one thing most important here, that see the matrix P4, see the matrix P4, P4 is equal to 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0. And again, see the matrix P5, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. Observe these two matrix. Out of these six matrix, these two matrix are non-symmetric matrix. That's why their transpose is not equal to its original value. That means P4 is not equal to its transpose. But if you observe, we can see that P4 is equal to transpose of P5 and P5 is equal to transpose of P4. That's why we can rearrange these values in the bottom equation and can continue our regular procedure by eliminating the transpose in the following equation. So P5 QB plus P6 QB. Now take the QB as a common, write P1 plus P2 plus P3 plus P4 plus P5 plus P6. Okay, and again right here QB. Okay, now we have to calculate this bracket value and then again multiply by Q and B. So here we will write this value. So just I will write the here again the matrices 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Again P2 is equal to 1 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0. Again P3 is equal to 0 1 0 1 0 0 0 0 1. P4 is equal to 0 1 0 0 0 1 1 0 0. P5 is equal to 0 0 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 and P6 is equal to 0 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 0. So these matrices are written over here. Now we have to calculate this bracket. If bracket ki value kya hai, hum is matrix se dhoond ke nikalenge. तो जो करस्पॉन्डिंग एलिमेंट है इन सब ब्रैकेट्स को तो ऐड करना चाहिए, यानी कि ये पहला एलिमेंट, इसका पहला, इसका पहला, इसका सबका पहला एलिमेंट पहला ऐड करना है, फिर दूसरा एलिमेंट, फिर तीसरा एलिमेंट. सो लेट्स कैलकुलेट द सम ऑफ दीज एलिमेंट्स. 1 प्लस 1 2 प्लस 0 0 0. सो फर्स्ट एलिमेंट बिकम्स, सो xb इज इक्वल टू फर्स्ट एलिमेंट बिकम्स 2. अगेन सेकंड एलिमेंट 1 प्लस 1 2, हियर इज 0, हियर इज 0. So it again becomes 2. Likewise, if you observe all these things values, you will get the matrices. Oh, sorry, matrix 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. This is the matrix. And again, what is the value of Q? Value of Q is that 2, 1, 3, 1, 0, 2, 3, 2, 1. And value of B is 1, 1, 1. Okay. Now we will again simplify this. Again we will simplify this. Let's simplify this. So we know the common rule of multiplication. We will directly write here the multiplication. First of all, we have to select one row and we have to select column of the second. Then below that we have to select second row. We have to write below this and again third row. We have to repeat this procedure for this column also, for this column also. So we will complete this procedure. First of all, 2 into 2 4 plus 2 into 1 2 plus 2 into 3 6. Here the row value of row is 2, same is all over there. Therefore we will write 4 plus 2 plus 6, 4 plus 2 plus 6. Now for the second column, the value will be 2 plus 0 plus 4, 2 plus 0 plus 4, 2 plus 0 plus 4. And for the third column, value will be 2 into 3, 6 plus 4 plus 2, 6 plus 4 plus 2, 6 plus 4 plus 2. Now these are the values. Now what is the value comes here? Write down. 4 plus 2 plus 6 becomes 12. Okay, is it right or not? It becomes 6, it becomes 12, it becomes 12, it becomes 6, it becomes 12. Again 12, 6, 12. This bracket gets closed. Sorry, matrices. And this matrix is vertical matrix, that is 1, 1, 1. Now last step is find out the multiplication of these two matrix. Again we get, if you do the multiplication, we will get we have to perform just an operation for one single column because it is a vertical matrix or column matrix, because it has only one column, that's why it is called a column matrix. So it will be converted into the column matrix. So write down 12 into 1 12, 6 into 1 6, plus 12. Again this row is gets multiplied with this column, 12 plus 6 plus 12. Again for the third row, again this situation becomes same. This becomes 30 30 30 vertical column matrix, 30 30 30 column matrix. So we know the equation x into 1 1 1 is equal to, here remove 30, that is take common 30 from out of this matrix, 30, it becomes 1 1 1. So we already know that x into this vertical bracket is equal to alpha, that is already given in the statement, x into 1 1 1 is equal to alpha into 1 1 1 matrix. So from this equation we can conclude that the value of alpha is also 30, that's why we will get alpha is equal to 30. So the option number 4 is correct. Option number 4 is correct. So now we will solve the option number 3, which was already made. हमने बताया था कि ऑप्शन नंबर 3 हम बाद में सॉल्व करेंगे, क्योंकि ऑप्शन नंबर 4 सॉल्व करने के बाद ही उसकी वैल्यू का पता चल सकता है. तो लेट्स सॉल्व द ऑप्शन नंबर 3 टू क्रैक द एग्जामिनेशन. सो व्हाट द ऑप्शन नंबर 3, इट्स राइट है ऑप्शन नंबर 3, एक्स माइनस 30i इज एन इनवर्टिबल मैट्रिक्स. X minus 30i is an invertible matrix. So now we know that X into B is equal to 30 into B. We know this, we have proved in the fourth option, X into B is equal to 30 into B. Now take this XB and 30B to the left side. It becomes XB minus 30B is equal to 0. Then we have to take B as a common, X minus 30, B is here, but here is the subtraction from the matrix. We cannot subtract a single number from a matrix, that why we have to write here in the matrix form. We can multiply it by identity matrix here, it becomes 0. So what again here, X minus 30i into B is equal to 0. Sorry, B gets 0, X minus 30i is equal to 0. But what is the actual condition kya hai bhaiya? Invertible ke liye condition kya hai? Malum hai kya aapko? Condition yaad rakhna hai, tabhi IIT mein pravesh mil sakta hai aapko. To condition ye hai ki jab determinant, ek matrix ka determinant ka value non zero hota hai, tab invertible matrix ka situation ke liye favorable hota hai. If the determinant of a matrix is a non-zero, then what is happen? Then its inverse exists. That means X minus 30i inverse exists if its determinant is zero. So multiply by this inverse to this original matrix, we will get X minus 30i into X minus 30i inverse is equal to 0. से मल्टीप्लाई करोगे तो 0 ही आएगा ना, बोथ द साइड्स मल्टीप्लाई करोगे तो कुछ नहीं होगा. तो उसका आंसर क्या आएगा जब हम उसको मल्टीप्लाई करेंगे, सॉरी इधर तो बी लिखना पड़ेगा, इधर बी है, सो वी हैव टू राइट द बी. सो ओनली बी इज रिमेनिंग हियर. सो व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस इफ यू मल्टीप्लाई अ मैट्रिक्स बाय इट्स इनवर्स, दैट इज ए इनटू ए इनवर्स, इट बिकम्स आइडेंटिटी मैट्रिक्स. सो आई इनटू बी इज इक्वल टू 0, आई इनटू बी इज इक्वल टू 0, there is nothing in the I, so B is equal to 0. Is it true? We have already known that value of B is 1 1 1 in the fourth example or second example. Value of B is 1 1 1, here value is coming 2. That's why the option number 3, that X minus 30i is an invertible matrix, is false. is not true, it is a false. So we have successfully completed our second example. Now we will go to our third example. I will write the example on the board. Due to the lack of projector, I am pausing the video and writing over here. I will write the third example, then we will continue.